Huntington, West Virginia, home of the Rose Garden of Ritter Park in Jones C. Edwards Stadium, the site for this game. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. We'll see how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. He'll return it from the three. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Under pressure, throws it, couldn't haul it in.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. And he's tackled it with positive yardage. Tackle at the 45-yard line.
You know, the wide receiver here does a good job of running a nice route, but I think it's the concentration, what he did at the end of the route, that made the difference. He felt the coverage. He knew that he had a man on him, but he's able to keep the defender away from the football and go up and make a nice catch.
Here's a give up the middle, tackled right away. Their own 45-yard line. It's second down. Nice run up the middle. Taken down around the 22-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22. He'll get it again. Nice run there.
That'll make it second and 4.
Here's the eighth play of the series. He gets out to about the 8. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. The middle for a nice game.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That brings up second and goal.
From the 1-yard line, it's second down. Quick throw, caught, touchdown. And he adds the extra point. a 10-play, 73-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
From his own goal line. And down he goes at the 30-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Throws a bullet. And he dropped it. Second and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line.
Think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Caught enough for the first down. And he can't hang on to it. So the stop there on third and long, and that's going to bring up a punting situation.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
He makes it out to about the 37-yard line. So now the offense comes back out, hoping for the same success they had on their last drive.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receiver. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
Quick out to his receiver.
That's a game seven on the play. That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Akron is up seven. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
I think you got to give credit to the big boys up front there. They're able to get this back to room that he needed.
The 13, and that play could have gone for six.
Oh boy, you're right. And all week long, this secondary did a lot of talking about how they were going to dominate these receivers. I think this is time that they step up and prove it on the field. Forget about talking trash. Let's see how they react after giving up that big play.
Tackle at about the 5-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And he is drilled at the 12-yard line.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
This one should be makeable. The kick is up. He clanks it off the upright. No good.
Anybody who tells you that football isn't a game of inches might want to have a talk with this kicker. It doesn't get any closer than that.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He airs it out. Dropped. It's second and 10. Ball on their own 20. Pressure.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none.
After one quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. The Zips with a touchdown lead. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. It's complete. Across midfield. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 30. Of a yard.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 31-yard line. Gets it out. He's met immediately. That's a loss of about 5.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Push him out at the 23-yard line.
That was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
It's fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Kicks away, and he just drilled it from long range. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Lawrence gets it at the 2. They'll bring him down at the 22. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Akron holds a 4-point lead.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. Tackle made to the 37-yard line. They were very fortunate to come up with that pass.
Not the smartest throw that he could have made, but it worked. It just makes you a little nervous when he lets that thing go.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. Inside the 30. The 10. He's all the way. Touchdown. Converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 26-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. And he's taken down at the 38. Got him, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. From their own 35-yard line, second down. And he just gets rid of it.
Here we go!
2-yard line. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
From their own 20-yard line, second down. Tight end grab, first down. And they make the stop around the 36-yard line. First down. From their own 39-yard line. Second down.
Mike 51, Mike 51.
Nearly intercepted.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
That'll bring up third and eight.
Trusts his arm and his receivers, but he's got to know when not to throw the ball. He didn't have any room at all, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted.
This is a great punt blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. Signals for a fair catch. So we're just about ready to return to action. They knock it down. Incomplete.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half. Tackled after a decent pickup. And they'll blow it dead.
False start offense.
They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
From their own 23-yard line, third down. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's out of bounds at the 30. Three and out.
Yeah, the defense did a great job of winning that series.
He's taken down at the 41-yard line. Akron's done what they had to do offensively. They've done a nice job here in the first half, Arthur.
Boy, it's been very consistent for them, and consequently, they have a nice lead here going into halftime. But again, they've got to be able to do a nice job here of continuing to fight, because this offense that they're facing across the line of scrimmage on the other side of the ball, they can score in a hurry, so there's still a lot of football to be played.
The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive, as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it. airs it out. Brought down at the 16.
That makes it first and 10.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. And down he goes at the 13. Hits the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the one. Brought down at the 28. It's still only the second quarter. We got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Quick strike to the receiver. They'll bring him down at about the 43-yard line. The pass results in a first down.
I'll tell you, great call by the coaches on first down. It stretches the defense when they're expecting the run, and then they end up with another first down.
Great tackle at the 47-yard line. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, it's a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. He might not be able to get the pass off. And he can't get away from the pressure. He's taken down around the 49-yard line. We've reached halftime, and I don't think too many people were expecting this. 21-3, Zips. Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Foster from the four. Tackle made at the 24. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Complete, brought down, nothing doing.
George on the tackle at the 25-yard line. That brings up second and nine.
The Zips will use their first time out of the half. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Receiver who's wide open, and he's tackled around the 35-yard line. Couldn't haul it in, but he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. He needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 35. Just shy of the first.
Good play call, almost perfect execution, except for the fact that they're not going to get the first down.
He fields a punt at the 20, and he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. And he's level at the 39.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 47. Going deep. And he's hit immediately. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked a perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
Oh, yeah, I'm coming. Oh, yeah, I'm coming. 51, Mike. Mike, 51.
He makes his way out to about the 9. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They come out in a five-wide set. He makes it to the 6-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide out look. Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown. He makes it 4 scoring passes.
Well, what we have right now is a quarterback who's very comfortable with his offense. He believes in his system, and the coaches and players believe in him. You couldn't ask for a better situation.
He makes the PAT. O'Leary looks ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line, he's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 29. Marshall's having a hard time doing anything on offense right now.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down, and they're forced to punt. Their drive ends up stalling in a fourth down. But they're moving the ball at times. I think they've just got to take some chances at this point late in the game like this. Throw the ball downfield and hope that the receivers can make some plays.
And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. A loss of about 6.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
So it's second and 16. Ball on their own 23. him hard at the 16-yard line.
Loss of 7 yards. That'll bring up third and long.
How you put a stop to a drive. That is an outstanding job with a pass rush.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. And he's tackled at the 36-yard line. Touchdown was the end result of their last drive as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Akron comes to the line holding that commanding lead. Touchdown, Akron! A powerful push by the line and a really nice run. That'll get you into the end zone almost every time. Converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Foster fields it at the 3. They'll bring him down at the 24-yard line. I hope they show some fight here and try to stay competitive. If you're going to get blown out, you at least want to go down swinging. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss.
That brings up second and 13.
Second and 13. Ball on the 21. Under pressure, throws it out, and it falls incomplete.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Slings it out there incomplete. Knight was the intended receiver on that pass. So they couldn't pick up the long yardage, and now they'll have to punt.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
Gets to about the 47-yard line. And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now, it's really paying off.
Oh, and he can't hold on.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 47-yard line, second down, the quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Nice run up the middle. Fourth quarter, and we didn't see this coming. The Zips are up big. They'll spread the field with five wide. Tackle made around the 34-yard line.
Johnson's in the tackle at the 34-yard line. First down.
Just about set to start the fourth quarter, mercifully. Akron looking to build on his commanding lead here. He's tackled around the 25-yard line. Fires quickly, and he's got his man.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Five wide.
51, Mike. Mike 51.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
Number nine was the intended receiver. That was in the third and inches.
Mike 51. Mike 51.
And he's taken down at the 23-yard line. From the 23-yard line, it's first down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throws incomplete. They got a hand on it.
Number 21 in the intended receiver. That makes it second and 10.
This is the eighth play of this drive. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
Well, I've seen some strange things in my day, but never anything like this. The kicker's on the field. He gets it up. And he just didn't have the leg for this one. I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here. But that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. And they make the stop around the 38-yard line.
There you go. Good read by the quarterback to give the offense a new set of downs. If the defense wants to line up and man, work that slant route until they stop it.
Just throws this one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Second and 10. Ball on the 38. And a quick throw. Brought down around the 43-yard line.
That'll bring up third and six.
Quick throw. He's got the halfback again. And down he goes. Right around the 42-yard line. And he muffed it. He's tackled at the 23. Kicker missed the field goal attempt the last time this offense had it. Let's see what happens this time around.
Anytime you have a shot at putting points on the board and you don't get it, you get a little frustrated. But this offense is very capable of scoring at any time.
That brings him second and five.
From their own 28-yard line, Second down. Akron looking to put this game away if they score here. He throws it. The defender had it and then dropped it.
That'll make it 35.
And pick up.
First down.
From their own 35-yard line. First down. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
First down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. Throws it to cover, it just picked off.
Misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 45.
Green 90.
Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage.
George takes him down behind the line at the 43-yard line. That brings up third as well.
Just over 2 minutes in the game. They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. They'll bring him down at the 41-yard line.
Number 11 takes him down for a loss behind the line at the 41-yard line. Fourth down.
And he can't hang on to the ball. He just couldn't pull that one in clean.
That's what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. This was an error that should have been avoided.
The main thing is they got the ball back, and now they can go to work on offense. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Woodson with a nice play fake. He wants it all. He's picked it off. This time it's the safety. And he's tackled at the 48.
Boy, it's been a long day for this defense, a day they'd probably like to forget about, but at least an interception like this is maybe some momentum for them, not just here today, but more importantly, as they look at the film of this game and try to build some confidence for the future, maybe this can help them.
Yards. He was tackled immediately. Loss of about two.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 50-yard line. Slings it. It's a fumble. And they fall on the loose ball. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with a turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
Late in the fourth quarter, this game's not even close. It's a blowout. A lot of folks have already gone home, and Herbie, I think we're going to make our dinner reservation. He's at midfield. Makes it out to about the 49.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 49. Under a minute left in the game. He lets it go. This one will fall incomplete.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense and alignment in a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Airing it out long. He's taken down around the 6-yard line. That's a deep move. That makes it first and goal. Now it's first and goal with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. And he is drilled at the 5-yard line. Come out on an empty backfield. To the end zone, intercepted.
That was just a sloppy pass, but for now, they can afford to live with it.
First and 10, ball on the 20-yard line. Akron's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Zips it to the back. He's out to the 30. Tackle around the 44-yard line. Marshall will take their first time out of the half. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Big opening. He makes his way to about the 42. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
They are stringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
Just throws this one away. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, Akron 35, Marshall 3. So that wraps things up for us. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.